It's the inside of the Blackfriars, everybody.
The scenery's changing, and it warms my soul. I'm 200 miles down and a long way yet to go.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jeremy Fiebig. I'm the artistic director and master of play at Sweet Tea Shakespeare, which is a small theater company in Fayetteville, North Carolina. And I'm here today to tell you about a new project that we have going on. We're building what I'm calling a living room. And I mean that in the deepest sense possible, where a room where life takes place, all right? So we've been around for 7 years, almost eight. And during that time, Sweet Tea Shakespeare has been mostly an itinerant theater company. I'm gonna tell you, but that means we just travel around a lot, and we don't exactly have a home, even though we have great, great hosts at the Museum of the Cape Fear Historical Complex, Holy Trinity Episcopal Church, St. Michael's, and lots of places around the region. But we're looking to change the game a little. What that means is that our actors and help, stage managers and others, show up at 5 o'clock to start putting up the scenery, the lights, the costumes. We pull all of that out of a storage place nearby, and we set it up for that night. And at 6:45, all of those people who are involved in our pre-show play live music for the audience members that are coming in. They had 15 minutes to go get into costume and take a breath, and then they're in the concert, in the pre-show. And then as soon as that pre-show is over, we're right into a production. And we've been doing that basically for 7 years. And so we're trying to give our actors and artists a bit of a break with this project. But equally as importantly, and more importantly in terms of our long-term future, what we're trying to do is put in place some pieces that will become part of our permanent home. And so what you see here are images and video interview about the American Shakespeare Center's touring playhouse. So they've used this for a few years. It is a scaled down, but absolutely beautiful version of their permanent structure, the Blackfriars Playhouse in Stanton, Virginia. It is the only reconstruction of Shakespeare's indoor playhouse in the world. And so this touring playhouse that they've used for several years is a version of that. And we're going to take that and we're going to mash it up with a seating area for a playhouse that we purchased last year from BEDLAM. BEDLAM is a marvelous theater company in New York City, and we're going to be able to mash those things together and create a lovely little pop-up 90 or so seat theater that has the Sweet Tea feel, but is basically creates a home, creates a living room wherever we are. We could put it in the middle of Hay Street. We could put it in the middle of a field. We could put it in a barn. And so whatever our long-term plans for a home become, these are really anchors of that experience. And we're very excited about them and grateful to the American Shakespeare Center for thinking of us. And so I just want to invite you to be a part of this story. You're going to see some images of all the different pieces and some of our shows. So you kind of have a feel for what the vision of this project is like. You'll see an interview between me and Ethan McSweeney, who's the artistic director of the American Shakespeare Center. And you'll see all of the details spelled out on our fundraising platform page. So you can take a look there. But we need partners. We need folks who want this playhouse named after them. We need folks who want to make these doors possible, to make these seating areas possible. So we're looking for partners and sharers in that experience. And we hope you'll join us. It's a really exciting time to be part of Sweet Tea Shakespeare in this experience of making a living room for Sweet Tea Shakespeare in the Fayetteville, Cumberland County community. Thanks. On,
and you walk in cold. We'll together leave our footprints at a pond.
It's going to find a home where it can continue to be part of inspiring creative work, and that makes me really happy. And the other is, what we learned was, it's just too well built to put up and take down 50 times a year. Like, it doesn't make sense for us. And I was like, you know, it's almost exactly right for what you're going to do with it, which is, it's portable, but not mobile. Yeah. I mean, there's a distinction, right, between like moving something every day and moving it two or three times a year or something.
Yeah, well, none of us are all right, but I was dead in the water. Get the kind of score with the recitations of the Paris poets popping rocks on.